Even though cattle have called the Bean Ranch home for more than 130 years, third-generation rancher Neil Bean is the first to tell you his primary focus is not cattle.
Grassland to us is everything. It's everything. It's our livelihood. It's the source for our livestock. Without the grass, there would be no reason for us to be ranchers or to care about taking care of it.
Neil is not the first in his family to think this way. For the most part, the family have left the native prairie be since his grandfather Ole staked his homestead claim on this prairie Coteau land in 1888.
That's why I give my ancestors a lot of credit. You know, we're proud of our ancestry, our roots, but we're also grateful for the land that those roots are embedded in yet today.
Through the years, the family have relied on cattle to help maintain grassland health.
So if you're going to have the soil protected and recycle the nutrients, there is only one way that I know, and that's through livestock and mainly cattle. And cattle are unique. They don't have any teeth on the top of their, like we do. And so when they eat grass, if they eat this grass, they literally tear the grass. And unbelievable to most people, that stimulates the grass to grow more and to have more photosynthesis take place. And that's what keeps the cycle between photosynthesis and respiration happening.
With more than 200 native grass species thriving on the Bean Ranch, cattle are quite content grazing the native prairie. Imitating migrating buffalo herds of the past, the family rotates the cattle herd through multiple pastures each year. The Beans are intentional about the rotation. They change up the time of year each pasture is grazed and choose not to graze some pastures.
Grass is like people to some extent. It needs a rest and a time to reinvigorate.
Native grasslands are not the only natural feature the family decided not to disturb. They also left their wetlands alone.
Wetlands have several functions, and of course wildlife, which I'm interested in, but they also reduce downstream flooding because they store water, they recharge the aquifer, and they also trap nutrients instead of running off down the river or into the lake, and then you get a big algae bloom. They stay up here where the water belongs.
Nate Bean said Tom Wickstrom is not joking when he talks about wetlands attracting wildlife.
There's lots of wildlife. That's probably one of the things that my grandpa and I are the most proud of, almost equivalent with the cow herd, you know, having the deer and the birds and the ducks, geese, everything that you have. And we have some of the most turkeys around in the area here. And, you know, people notice that too. And I can sit on the porch of my house, drink a cup of coffee in the morning, and just watch like three or four does walk around and kind of eat some grass in the morning and stuff. And that's also a big part of the decisions and the management that goes into how we manage this place.
Nate Bean is Neil's grandson. After graduating from South Dakota State University last spring, he returned to the family ranch and plans to carry on his grandpa's conservation legacy, leaving resources like grasslands and wetlands be, just like Mother Nature intended, is not typical, explains Pete Bauman, SDSU Extension Natural Resources Field Specialist.
That's unique about Neil and the ranch and the family is, in a lot of conservation stories, we tell those stories about how something went wrong or a choice was made, and then there's a generation or two or a span of time where that mistake maybe is being fixed. A lot of conservation stories center around replacing wetlands, replacing the prairie that was lost, restoring grasslands. There's not a big piece of that story here on the ranch because they never made those decisions to begin with. They conserved. They practiced the slow and I think patient art of learning with nature.
In 2022, the Bean family were recognized for their conservation efforts with the Leopold Conservation Award.